No.
I drink all your gin.
Oh, hey, YouTube. Nothing says Christmas more than just one or two chocolates and a fizzy beverage at Christmas time, and of course the Morecambe and Wise Christmas show. If you're from my generation, then this was the staple of our Christmas entertainment. And some of you may know or may not know that I was actually born in Morecambe. And Eric Morecambe was one of my comedy heroes. And last September, when we were in the UK, I went back to my hometown, back to my roots, to check out Morecambe, look at some of the places I used to go, and of course see a statue of Eric. So come with me, and let's go!
Bring me sunshine in your smile. Bring me laughter all the while. In this world where we live, there should be more happiness. So much joy you can give to each brand new bright tomorrow. Make me happy through the years. Never bring me any tears. Let your arms be as warm as the sun from up above. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love, sweet love. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love.
Hey. YouTube, it's Theme Park Bazza here with...
This is Bazza.
And today we are in my hometown, the beautiful Morecambe Bay. So I moved away from here when I was 2 years old, but this is my hometown. I think Max has been here a couple of times. Show you a couple of the... check out some of the things. Probably look at some old memories, try and recurdle some old memories of mine back in the day. But it's beautiful today. The sun is out, the sky is blue, 20 degrees, maybe 18 degrees,
18
centigrade.
Degrees.
But come with us and we'll have a look around Morecambe together. So this is the classy Midland Hotel. It's been renovated recently. Back in the day when I was young, this was like where the posh people came and stayed in Blackpool, because we did have posh people, sorry, in Morecambe. We did have posh people in Morecambe at one time. So it's been renovated now. I think my mum and sister stayed here. They also do high teas on a or during the week as well. It's very classic 1920s, 1930s Art Deco style of building. And again, there's people in here having high tea now, I think. So it's a Midland Hotel, very famous, right on the front here at Morecambe. Looks like they now have a fun fair down this end. Of course, they used to have pleasure land here back in the day. Even I remember that. Some of that got torn up and got sent up to Blackpool. It was themed as Frontierland, I think it was called. I get the right term for it. It was Frontierland. It was themed as a cowboy park. I did ride a roller coaster there once when I was very young. It scared the life out of me. And they had that big tower, like I dropped out like a polo mint.
Did they?
I think it ended up going to Blackpool at one point. But unfortunately, that's just an abandoned site now. And unfortunately for Morecambe, a lot of places are abandoned, which is a shame because it's still a very, very nice town. Maxine wonders if this used to be the swimming pool at one time, because there's a sign here that says take the plunge. Let me know if you know what this area used to be where this fun fair is now. There was a sign here, again this Art Deco type styling, that says take the plunge. Swim unaided, self-propelled from deep to shallow. Could have been a swimming thing at one time, that Max, couldn't it?
Looks like it.
Yeah, it does look like it.
Yeah, I don't know,
they
used to have one in Blackpool, didn't they?
Yeah. I believe that over there is the Winter Gardens. Like you have in Blackpool as well, sort of the big shows used to be in here. A lot of the big stars. My granddad used to work at the Winter Gardens, he was the doorman, so I got to meet a lot of the celebrities like Morecambe and Wise, Jimmy Tarbuck, all the ones who were playing here in the 60s and 70s. But very ornate. I think it says Winter Gardens on the door there. Very ornate building. Right next to Pleasureland, where you can go and get all your arcades. When the sea was in, as a kid, I remember coming down here. Maybe it's further along there. But you just used to hang a string off the edge here and try and fish for crabs. I remember getting them. I think it's further down there where the rocks went, or maybe these rocks went here then. But all this, when this, you can see how far it comes in, this tide. But where we were, it was way up here. And we used to, yeah, brings about a few happy memories of my childhood. And the reason I remember so much of that is we used to come here every summer, stay with my gran and granddad. They lived here. Get the train from Skipton. I'll show you the the railway station. That's my first memory of living here, was getting in that railway station in the holidays in July, spending them down here in Morecambe. Sunny Morecambe today. So no trip to Morecambe would be complete without meeting up with Eric Bartholomew, otherwise known as Eric Morecambe, as he took his name from the town. If you wonder where my humour came from, it was watching this gentleman in the 70s in their Christmas shows. One of my heroes, comedy heroes, him and Ernie Wise. So he has proud position statue here, right in the centre of Morecambe. So this place where we just went for coffee, I'm showing you some pictures inside, is a listed building. It's called Bruchani. 1893 it opened and has been a coffee bar since 1930s, and it's right next door to the Winter Gardens I showed you earlier. So it's a grade 2 listed building, so they can't change it. But Costa's just next door, but why would you not want to go in and try somewhere like this? You saw a very, very unique architecture inside there, the original panelling from 1939. Well, we just tried our luck in the arcade, didn't we, Max? With 2p's. But they're all tickets these days, aren't they? You don't win a prize, just get tickets on penny falls.
Not the same.
We did go on the 2p falls, we did splash out on 20p, didn't we? Just like Vegas. So now walking up to the railway station, again, my first early memories of coming here. Coming off the trains. They used to run here from Skipton. I don't think they run this to this station anymore. There is another station further down the line. It's been converted into many things as this. I think at Christmas it was a food bank, because from the shore, we're doing a charity, getting a food bank stuff together. I think now it was for an event, wasn't it? They had it for events. Looks like there's a restaurant or cafe here, but we'll have a quick look round, see if we can get inside the station, as it's now called. This end part here is actually a pub, the station pub. And then here is the old facade where we used to get the taxis. We used to come up here. This used to be like a roundabout to go out, but they used to pull up here in front of the main station. So that is a pub. I think it's tourist information in the middle. We can maybe have a quick look in. I'd like to see some of the architecture, see if it's still open. So we're now looking at the tourist information. Kind of see some of the, you can see through there, they've got tables and chairs set out for the private event. You can see some of the main arrivals area there, the trains used to come in inside, and the architecture. So this piece of land here, this derelict land, used to be Frontierland, and also back there where Morrison's is. Now I believe Morrison's have purchased this piece of land as well here. So this used to be the big theme park. Now it's just all boarded in, boarded over. Which is a shame, but
prime real estate,
because more and more shops going up, I guess. So this road here is Scholar Green Lane in Morecambe, and my granddad's house was here on the corner, number 90. It's kind of, I always thought it was a detached house, but obviously it was a semi-detached. And they had a huge, where this garage is here, and I'll just move across because you're in the sunlight. Where this garage is here, they used to have a huge garden out back. Used to go and play in. I always remember it being very small in there, that this was a garden, and this was their house. I always remember it being on the corner. And I do believe, Paul Rahurd used to live further down there, on that side of the road. I remember him telling me, but so this is where we used to come as kids all the time, during the summertime. 90 Scholar Green Lane. Seems weird being back here. Everything seems bigger, maybe because, I should say everything seems smaller, maybe because I'm bigger. But yeah. And there used to be an abattoir down the road that you really don't want to know, but I always remember there being an abattoir down the road and blood running down the grates, but I'll probably edit that out of the vlog for obviously reasons. And this is about 5 minutes from the railway station and 5 minutes from downtown. Interesting. So there is the house, 90 Scholar Green Lane. I won't film too much because there's people in it, obviously. But yeah, good to relive old memories. So now we're going to head off to Heysham, not Heysham as the tourists say, and meet it with a couple of old friends again and go out for a bite to eat. So next shot you see, we should be having a walk with a couple of friends. to the beach here at Heysham. Apparently that's Cookie's Beach because we have a tour guide here.
Yeah.
That you might recognise.
Mr. Hello.
This is Dave.
Yeah, I think Dave or Jeff, something
Jeff.
Like that. Yeah.
It's Baz from the shore.
Yep.
Who lives locally and our tour guide, and he's going to take us to some of his favourite haunts. That'll probably include a pub. Because we're here.
Yeah.
Look at the views though, it's just a beautiful day. And that's the Lake District over there, is it?
Yes, yeah.
In the distance. We couldn't get over getting here, even from Blackpool was like over an hour, because you've got to come right in, up the coast and right out again.
Yeah.
This bay is huge. Morecambe Bay. Is it still Morecambe Bay here?
Heysham comes all the way around.
Yeah.
From beyond there, it comes all the way around.
Yeah.
To just where that building is down there.
Yeah.
And then you've got Morecambe Bay which goes round.
Round and in, yeah.
And then you're going round into Barrow and places like that.
Cool. Our second guest has joined us. Oh, Baz and Tina.
Hello.
From the shore.
Yay.
Yep. Some of our favourite friends here join us for a meal in the Royal in Heysham. Mm-hmm. So I'll put a few clips of the Royal going to go and have a nice meal now. And Max is here as well. And we will see them.
Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love, sweet love. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring